Hi, welcome back to GP Rectrums. Hope you're good. Have you hope you're having a great weekend? And as always, thank you for subscribing. I'm going to be listening to a bit of Genesis now, and this track "Turn It On Again." I was hoping to kind of look at actual live version from the Duke Tour, taken from the Lyceum Ballroom in 1980. Unfortunately, the quality doesn't look great. So I'm instead going to be playing the nice little video compilation for the Freeside Live. I think it was on the Freeside Live video, probably DVD, and I'm hoping that YouTube allow this, so there's no copyright issues. And this was taken from the Abacab tour, and I know this song really, really well. I've never really kind of stopped and listened to it specifically, the lyrics or anything, but I'm kind of very, very aware of this track. It was kind of very popular even when I was a kid, beyond how popular Follow Me was in 78. This was the next kind of really big one that they had in 1980. But I'm still kind of excited to kind of get into this, and I haven't sort of seen this particular video, although I do know from what my brother said that this is, it's kind of like a compilation. A lot of the tracks have clips from other stuff, so it's not, so I'm assuming that this won't be entirely a live video. So yeah, having said all this, yeah, really kind of looking forward to listening to it, and trying to kind of find out what the lyrics are really about. So without further ado, okay. I always love the beginning of this. Sorry, I'm just going to pause it there. I really, really love this video, and it kind of just shows everything that's going on that surrounds the band when they're having their intimate moments with their families, to, you know, photographers, the press, and even the roadies vacuuming the stage. I kind of really love videos like this. Don't often see this kind of like compilation of performance and backstage activities, but when I do, I kind of really enjoy these kind of things. I'm loving the song, actually. Now I always thought this song was essentially just a person who's angrily saying that to someone, I can show you some of the people in my life, but I'm beginning to kind of think there's a little bit more to this song, and I kind of think it might be like an obsession with the image of television media, and and that the fantasy of the media is kind of like realities, the reality of like living is not so as important as what is happening on the radio and on television, and that there's like a blurring of lines between what is part of your life and what is just media. So yeah, it's quite an interesting song. Oh, by the way, I do actually know that I'm pretty sure Phil Collins was a Queen's Park Rangers football fan, and I believe that his sweatbands are particular to that football team. So just thought I'd throw that out. So Genesis with Turn It On Again, and that was fantastic. The thing I love about this song and the imagery that initially I kind of always get when I first hear it begin is that it actually feels like I should be driving into a big city on a massive highway with this blasting out of my speakers, and that just really kind of like sets the mood for me. And for sure, in the video, the first image is driving on a massive highway into a city. And it's just a fantastic driving record. I love it. It's kind of like that bass. I think it's a bass at the beginning. But that is great. And there's some great drum work towards the end as well. I've not really listened to too many live versions of this. And this is the first time I've kind of probably heard this live version or seen a video of this live version. I may have heard this live version off the album Three Sides Live, but not for quite a long time. And yeah, it's a really, really interesting lyrics as well. As I said, like halfway through, I kind of like always thought that this might just be about somebody trying to express trying to get across to another person how they live, you know, look at my life sort of thing. But now I'm kind of looking at it. It kind of has a different sort of feel to it. I tried to listen as much as I could to the lyrics. But it was kind of like hard at the same time because there's so much going on in the video, which I was enjoying. And I having a look at having a great time as well backstage. So yeah, I'm going to have a quick look at the lyrics and see what I can draw out of them. All I need is a TV show, that and a radio. Down on my luck again, down on my luck again. I can show you some of the people in my life. It's driving me mad, just another way of passing the day. I get so lonely when she's not there. So this is where I kind of like first thought it might be something to do with somebody who's obsessing over watching television rather than actually more than they are about kind of living in the real world. And when it says, I get so lonely when she's not there, it could be taken to kind of mean that it's a real life person in their life, but because of the other stuff where it says, all I need is a TV show, that and the radio, I kind of get the feeling that the female in this scenario is actually somebody on television. So there could be a hint of stalking here, I'm not sure. You're just another face that I know from the TV show. I have known you for so very long. I feel you like a friend. Not I feel like you're a friend. I feel you like I feel a friend, like a friend. Can't do anything for me. Can I touch you for a while? Yeah, so that's kind of really sort of feeding into my idea that this guy might be obsessing a little bit too seriously about a particular person on television. As we know, these things can sometimes transfer to real life. Can I meet you on another day and we will fly away? I mean, this could literally just be about the pressures of the touring, I suppose, but I kind of feel that this is about somebody obsessing about a particular person on television, and they're trying to kind of justify their this particular form of existence. When I say, I can show you some of the people in my life. Yeah, I think he's fantasizing about a relationship. I mean, that might be very innocent if we've all kind of seen people on television and there are thoughts in our heads that, you know, we wouldn't necessarily kind of speak out loud. And this could just be his thoughts turning over, you know, trying to justify himself that, you know, he's down on his luck again. And that this is the situation he's found in. Maybe he's unemployed. Maybe that's all he has to do at the moment during the day. He's kind of watch television, and that's his kind of justification for doing it. But it's a great record anyway. It's just a great rock song. Without even looking into it, and I kind of love everything about this song. It's just the right length as well. Not too long. I've heard a kind of longer sort of version of his live, and to me it doesn't work. To me it kind of drags out. It feels like they're trying to stretch something out that shouldn't be stretched out. So this actual live version, which I'm kind of assuming was probably the real time length of it, was just literally just perfect for me, and I really enjoyed it. Perfect for a Saturday as well. So guys, hope you enjoyed that, and please join me in the comments below if you have any thoughts about it. And until next time, take care of yourselves. I'll have plenty more Genesis for you, as always. And I'm not kind of sure what's next on the list, but I'm trying to kind of follow the Duke schedule as much as I can, the Duke set list. I have kind of gone a bit off-piste with it, with some tracks, because I've just literally wanted to find the best, maybe his live or quality version of that track. So yeah, till next time, take care of yourselves and have a great weekend.